should be good to go here. Oh wow, that's really quiet now. Why is it so quiet? That's probably why. Okay, so it is Saturday here, and we are doing my stream, like I do every Saturday, or at least try to. Recently, it's kind of not been happening because I've been, you know, bad at it. Bad at actually following a schedule, sleeping in way too late. I mean, I did the same today, but... Either way, we are, we're just gonna do some Isaac stuff. Feels like my post-it note was changed. Yeah. What the heck happened here? Okay, something... Yeah, so my post-it note is completely different now, I guess. I guess we lost most of our completion. Because I know we did not do anything on normal mode. We did all this stuff on hard. Okay, what the f... That's... That kinda sucks. I hope it's not as bad as I think it is. But it seems like we lost everything. Which, you know, means back to... Back to, My save files were deleted. Or at least my saves weren't deleted, but I seem to have lost progress. Which is, you know, lovely. It's amazing, actually. Makes me feel so good about my progress I made in this game. And the idea that I'm coming back to play it. So, I guess since, yeah, we don't have any hard mode notes unlocked anymore on most characters. We don't have Greed or Greedier done on anyone except Azazel or Eden. Let's just do an Apollyon, or let's just fix this with an Isaac run. We're gonna need to start working these back up again. It has actually been a while since I played Isaac too, so... Seems kind of framey, actually. Butterbean. Not... Oh, yeah, I'll take the relic. Relic pretty much guarantees a win. Is this XL? No, it's just basement. Okay. We are off to a very good start here, I would say. The relic is an amazing pickup this early on. Watching on your rabbit. What is that, like a phone or a tablet or something? This is just a bomb for a bomb. It's a bomb for a bomb. Not really like the most worthwhile trade, but oh crap, frame rate drops. I might need to close something, but I'm gonna check, I'll check my task manager in just a sec when this room's done. Let's check, task manager really quick, because we should not be, having frame rate drops or anything like that. Task manager is not responding. CPU is sitting at about 80%. What's taking up the most? Some audio graphic device recognition thing. And, yeah. Whatever, it doesn't matter. But it's working pretty much fine. Anyway, I'm just gonna try and get back down to... What was it? I wanna get... Post-it notes start to get that filled up again, but we're gonna start with some easy stuff first, because it's been a while since I played. That was kind of dangerous. I will spend bombs for more keys at this point. Yeah, two bombs for two keys is a pretty good trade. Secret room possibilities so far seems like pretty much anywhere. Could be above, could be below, could be above or below in the next room. Okay, never mind. It could be... we're gonna get a battery, I think, from this. Let's wait until after this room, because if this is a 48-hour energy, it's not. Okay, so we can reroll the boss room if it's bad. So that is under the assumption that it is bad. Oh, wow, that was awful damage. Hate these guys so much. Least favorite enemy. Early on, at least. A key. And let's spend a bomb to blow these up. That is a lot of money. We got our key. We got a key back. And we got are you a wizard? Second secret room is probably here. Nope. Okay. I almost have enough money to go to the shop. You know what? I think I'm going to go into the shop, and if there's like something half price, I can buy it. We have enough keys that I can justify wasting one. Black candle would have been really nice to have, but I don't think we can... I don't think it's... I just think it's not possible for us to get it. And now that this is worn off, let's go fight the boss, and maybe if we get Pageant Boy, we'll come back and get Black Candle. Oh, Larry Jr. Easy fight. Though I'm gonna probably take damage, all things considered, because I said it's easy, so I'm gonna end up biting it. Or, jinxing it. It's been a while since I actually played... Oh, crap. Oof. Phew. That was kind of close, but... This is a new room layout, too. I feel like I haven't seen this layout before, so maybe there was a patch recently that added new stuff? Okay, there we go. We got the PJs. Which, you know, I'm just gonna take them. And we're just gonna go down. Probably should have rerolled them, because we just got a bunch of spirit hurts instead of a stat up at this point. Probably would have been better to go for... Probably would have been better to try and get a stats up of some kind instead of these extra spirit hearts, because this doesn't actually make us more powerful. It just pretty much guarantees that we're going to get a devil room. Yeah, I don't know how I'm supposed to be avoiding the enemies here when they move so erratically. And they're all champions. Why is my damage so pathetic right now? Well, I mean, I know why my damage is pathetic. It's because I don't have any damage ups. There we go. Okay. So I know someone wanted to talk to me about what games I should stream. Because they wanted me, you wanted me to stream something for a group, But we need to figure out what exactly that is and come up with a list for everyone to vote on. But I guess we could talk about that, or we could wait until, I was gonna say during Metroid Prime, but I think that's more stressful than this. More tense. I will totally come in here. Oh, we got poison bombs. Cool. So I can break this, but I'm gonna check this first. Two more. Okay, this is... Yeah, so far this is 100% worth it. I could have rerolled the poison bombs, but I figured having them for opening that stone chest and possibly getting something good from it was probably a better trade. But it didn't work out. So since we have a blood bank, we can go to the shop on this floor, guaranteed. I'm gonna wait until after the boss to use it, though. Okay. Book of Secrets is trash. We can use it to find our secret rooms, though, and then I'll reroll this. Into, you know what, Concussive Tears are okay. They're not great, but we're gonna wanna have a reroll for, the Devil Deal. I will spend the Bomb and a Key for a sack. It paid out not really worth it. Could have paid out with up to four items, so I figured it was a good try. We'll come check this out. And that's an HP upgrade. Which I'm just gonna take at this point. A High Priestess card pretty much means that whatever boss we fight is dead. Play this thing down to half a spirit heart. I could afford to go a little deeper on it. I don't think I'm going to. We got a boss trap room also, so I will give that a check. There's yet another spirit heart. It's not worth it. That is not even close to worth it. The 9 volt. Yes, please. 9 volt is lovely. Especially because it'll give us a reroll for the boss fight. So we're kind of still lacking in stat ups, other than Iron Bar, which I guess is a damage up. I didn't even know. Honestly, Monster was not even enough of a problem for me to want to use the High Priestess on him, but I will. And we'll miss! Just goes to show that I will curse it every time I do something. So Rayman Origins, Cave Story to the Moon. I don't have Rayman Origins, but I have the other two. I could totally do either of them. To the Moon, if you like watching me cry, I can do that. Cave Story, I haven't played it in a while. It's a nice, fun little time sink. So I wouldn't mind doing that either. Get it done in like one or two streams. HP upgrade isn't that good. And then Satanic Bible and Lil Brimstone. You know, that kind of sucks, honestly. I think we would just reroll them both. Because I don't like Lil Brimstone much. Actually, no, let's take Lil Brimstone. And then we'll take Multidimensional Baby and we'll take the HP up. And we'll go down. Yeah, Cave Story would be good, but if there's like any GameCube, like Super Nintendo games or anything like that, if you want to see me play a Fire Emblem or... I don't know, even MMOs or something that like multiple people could get in on. Okay, Lil Brimstone actually sped this up a whole lot. Let's go in here, because... Man. Sadly, it wasn't worth it this time, but... We have enough HP that it's not a big deal. I'm just, like... Yeah, like, if we got, say, four people or so who wanted to, like, join in and do, like, a group session, we could play, like, Mario Party or Mario Kart or something. Something silly like that. The only problem is I don't really have a ton of multiplayer games on Steam. So, yeah. Okay, another spirit heart, another bomb. I'm not even gonna break those because it'll just tempt me. Oh, we got a double key room. That is, I'm gonna give that a try. For sure. We have all our special rooms right here. A six room. Okay. So let's come in here, see, do we like our item? Continuum? Honestly, not that great. Especially because we need a bigger range to even make use of it. But let's reroll. Rare card is not good enough, but we can pick it up and use it. And then in here, you know what this half price card might be? Two of spades, double our keys, two keys for 3 cents is good. And let's totally do this. Oh, we got more damage. We lost the relic. Do we have Epiphora? We do. Perfect. I love that item. We have a very good run now. Other than the fact that we lost our relic. Explosivo too. Like this is a really powerful run now. Holy crap. Goodbye. Ah. Tried to keep Epiphora going. Didn't work out very well. I mean, I really like this item. I don't know why it gets a bad rap. It's such a big damage up. That it quadrupled my DPS just here. Let's go check this last room out, actually. While we're here. It's absolutely nothing. Yeah, we two-shot enemies at this point. This is very good. Gertie. That was awful damage. Oh, we have Gimpy too. That's good to know. Gertie is dead. Yeah, we absolutely destroy these bosses now. Explosivo Epiphora means just we get more and more bombs on the enemy. And we still have a decent amount of HP. You're pretty much dead. The moment you explode, you're dead too. Any time a shot sticks to an enemy, we know it's dead. You're not. Right. Okay. At least get a bit of a stat tears up from this. Yeah, this is exceptionally powerful right now. The only times it gets even remotely weak are when we have to turn around. Like rooms like this where we wouldn't be able to hit enemies unless we're aiming in another direction. Joker card is lovely. we found our secret room. Wait, why do we have invincibility? What gave us invincibility? Virgo? I thought that was... Oh, we got... Okay, we got a skinny odd mushroom, which... actually kind of sucks. I'm pretty sure it's going to bring us down to 3 still. No, it brings us down to 2. Okay, that kind of sucks, ultimately. It's speed up, damage up, or damage down. But it means Epiphora is gonna... We have a faster fire rate once Epiphora gets maxed out. Oh well. Could have been worse. Could be better. I mean, we still have a, now we have a good fire rate outside of Epiphora too, so it kind of also resolves more of our issues on top of that. There's our special room. Jesus, we hit this guy so much that he gets knocked back to the point where we can hit him. Oh no. Oh no. I don't know what to think about this anymore. We need rubber cement. That's what we need at this point. I think rubber cement would make this amazing. But look at our, look at, just these this wave of nails. I almost walked into that. Wall of pain, pretty much. Stain, kind of sucks, especially because our explosivo shots aren't gonna stick. Until they do and kill him. We got Binky, which is, you know, it's supposed to be a tears up, but we're already at the cap, so I guess we'll just go down. Depths 1. What's in here? Just, yeah, that's not worth it. We need something to make this a bit better, because it was good and then we picked up skinny odd mushroom and then we picked up the whiz, which isn't really bad. It's just a worse 2020, which kind of does make it bad, but that's hard. That's, you know, 2020 is one of the best items in the game, so check this out. This is kind of trash, but... We bombed an enemy so hard that it bombed another enemy into a, That's 100% guaranteed chance already, so there's no point in blowing him up. Power pill? No thanks. Rather hold on to this Joker card. I should have used it last floor. What am I doing? Money equals power is good. Good enough to take. Already gave us like 0.5 damage up. And now we do want to blow this guy up. Get more money. Okay. Yeah, every penny we get gives us 0.05? I thought it was 0.04. Huh. Maybe, do we have a damage multiplier of some kind? I didn't think we did. Oh well. Oof. Almost took damage because I sneezed. The big problem with this is that it's really hard to reliably hit things and be able to dodge at the same time. Oh, wow. We just got, like, half damage up right there. Second secret room is useless. And then here we're gonna get little Gish, which I guess will help with our issue. Slightly. Not a ton, but it'll help a little. I don't think, sadly, I don't think our Explosivo is going to help a whole lot on this fight. Especially considering whenever he jumps, it, deactivates. Okay, there we go. And then we're gonna get a devil room. Pretty much guaranteed, I think. Yeah, we'll grab Gish. And 5 red chests. It's kinda not what I wanted. Considering it's spiders and more spirit hearts that I don't need. Well, we can check the pills. I can see forever is kind of useful if we didn't find our actual secret room, but I think we're already done with this floor. Because we don't want, we don't want to go to the shops because we want money equals power to work. Well, actually, we probably would have wanted to go to the shop in case it was greed. I think I'm just going to use this Joker... No, I'm not going to use this Joker card right away. Wait until after the boss. Best. We're not in a bad enough situation where we need it to survive. Explosivo shot that enemy so strongly that it got launched into me. Wow. More cards. Is it, if this is another Joker card... Do I use it now or... I think that didn't quite go as I wanted it to, but it still went pretty well, I'd say. I'm actually just going to use this now and hold on to the Joker. Why am I still at full red hearts? Oh, because blood bag, right. Yeah, we're doing really good now. I just need some way to more reliably hit things. Which means this whiz shot needs to freaking go. Or we get rubber cement. Rubber cement just turns everything into complete chaos, where everything dies instantly. Sun. Let's just use it for the map effect. Come in here. Honestly? We blow both of you up. Blow you up. More damage? Holy crap. And we play the crap out of you. Contract from below right away? Yeah. Yes, please. Bomb you for 0.03. Oh, money equals power get like a scaling damage up? For like the more money you have, the smaller the damage up is? That actually makes it even better. These guys are freaking impossible to hit like this. Grab that. Right, we need to go to the item room. We cannot just skip our item rooms. We are not powerful enough to skip our item rooms. Mini boss is possibility of an HP upgrade at least. Or I mean I think it's Yumheart from Super Gluttony. Doesn't matter anyway, so. This is actually taking a lot longer than I thought it would. This run. Number one does literally nothing for us except give us a range down. I don't really know how to deal with that, but oh well. Tarot cloth doubles the effect of our tarot cards. Is it worth 15 cents though? Is it worth some of our damage? Or would we rather turn it into something else? I don't think it's worth it. I'll bomb, maybe there's something else here, but I can't really think of anything that would be worth it. Car battery is not worth it. Pill bottle is not worth it. That is not worth it at all. That is very much not worth it. Extra keys is not worth it either. Actually, that means chests have more stuff in them. Then we'll probably get our investment back. It was a 0.5 damage down to take it, but we'll get our money back when we open enough chests. Can I come in there? No. I don't know how much red hearts I have, so I'd rather not play that. We did already go into this. Did we go into the secret room? No, I don't think we did. So why do we have it revealed? Weird. Oh well. my hand is falling asleep. It is not very much not good. Either way, we're gonna... Oh, we're already at Mom? Wow. It's Red Mom, which actually makes this kind of even more annoying. It means we aren't actually gonna be able to do any explosivo shots. But, I mean, we do a fair bit of damage. Take the Polaroid, use the Joker. And it's Krampus. Lovely. Totally worth it. Well, actually, you know what? No matter what we get, it's worth it. Lump of Coal makes our damage even better. The Devil and the Devil. Sure. Let's go down. Why are my nails so small now? Is that what Lump of Coal did? You're fucked. Get absolutely destroyed. There's nothing here. It is really dark. The bright side, our damage seems to be pretty darn spectacular. I don't know why our tears are so small suddenly though. Polycephalus. Hey buddy, you wanna pop up so I can destroy you? The whiz in rooms like this is absolutely awful. Because we just have walls on every single side, pretty much. I can't justify it at this point. I don't have enough HP. And I can't see Tinted Rocks because I'm awful at it. And also, Curse of Darkness really sucks. That was really close. This is totally worth it. Unless we get hit like 5-6 times. We got most of our damage back though. Yep, Chubb is very much dead. Oh, is the Explosivo plus 8-inch nails what's making us take so much damage when we get like, when enemies explode and get knocked into us? That sounds very possible. I don't even know what hit me there. What am I supposed to do about that? Okay, we need to beat this without getting hit. Daddy long legs, which means we're probably not going to do that. Yep, just randomly get hit. Perfect. There goes our devil chance. And we're probably gonna die, honestly. This run went from good to awful the moment we picked up the whiz. This pretty much changes my opinion of this from a good item to complete trash. I can't freaking hit anything. Oh, it's this room. Well, the Lovers gives us full HP. The world at least lets us see the map. We got a luck up, which means Tough Love is going to activate more often. I'm just bad at this game, I think. At this point, I think that's what I've realized. Though that 1-4 with Curse of the Blind kind of fucked me so much. Skinny Odd Mushroom, which, you know, is not that big of a deal. But considering we've gotten enough tiers upgrades to put us at the cap anyway. Just kind of sucks, ultimately. I will take Bible Tract. Actually, no, I'm going to take Baglon. No, we'll take Bible Tract. And what was in here? Nothing. In here, a battery. Yeah, there goes my devil chance. Might as well go to the curse room now. It's like the perfect assortment of awful items to have. Explosivo, which is normally really good, combined with Whiz Shot, which means that you can't really control where you're, like, some of them are getting on things you don't expect them to get on. Combined with Epiphora, which means we're near constantly getting bombs on enemies that launch everything around. With the 8-inch nails, which makes it so that our freaking bombs knock back enemies even further. It's just the perfect assortment of items to make this run, like, dangerous as heck. Well, we have a 36% chance of a devil room now. We can only get hit once, still. Okay. Almost at the damage cap from money equals power. First, I'll just take damage anyway, so, you know, all okay. Might be a little salty at this point. And then our greed fight is probably gonna take away my devil chance. Or it'll put us to the damage cap. Fire, like, this wall of tears out here. Yeah, this is where we die. Oh, nope, never mind. Okay. Or at least lose our devil chance. Oh! Thank God you gave me some sort of... Oh, you gave me a break. Back in secret rooms. Blackheart, please? 5 pills. Helipills? Not that big of a deal. I can see forever doesn't change much. And lemon party. And there's a pheromones. Lovely. Okay, let's get up to 2 tier delay. And proceed to go get our ass kicked. Wow. That's a lovely oh, there we go. Say goodbye to my devil room chance because I hate these enemies. And that'll finish off Monsart. We are very good against single targets. That's what I've realized. If we get invincibility, we just get in there, get like 20 bombs up, 20... explosivo shots charged up or something like that, and then we just step back and dodge and everything dies. really? Really? I'm like one pixel away from being able to get that. Oh. Right, we have placenta. Forgot about that. There's no chance of devil rooms anymore, so I will go in here. This was not worth it at all. Unless one of these... is Burkano rune. It's not really what I wanted, but... I guess it paid for itself in the end. I don't know. Come on. Gertie is very much dead. We just have to hope one of those doesn't explode when he's, like, moving towards us. Or doing his run, because then he'll just get exploded in our general direction and probably bounce off the walls a ton. Okay. We might still be able to pull out a win. Actually, I think we're past the part of the game where it's at its hardest. Once we got through the womb, we started focusing more on big, strong enemies instead of a bunch of weak ones, which is where the issues of bad damage come in. We should be able to do this now, actually. Maybe. I say as I don't take damage. Why did the music stop? Does the music normally just completely stop when you get a secret room? I thought it just goes quiet for like a second and then fades back in. Pinky Eye is, you know, not that great. Oh, wait, that was our spirit heart we lost, right? Okay. Second secret room has 3 spirit hearts. Lovely. I could fight the angel, but there's no point. Okay, we're at the third phase already. Yeah, we are gonna be able to make it through this. There we go. Down to the chest. I'm hoping I get some decent items here. Curse of the Blind again, lovely. Except it's not. We get Magic Fingers, which, you know, is okay. Yo, listen. Glaucoma. And how to jump. That's not really that useful. Magic Fingers would be good, except our big source of damage is money equals power. Yo, listen is pretty much useless because we're already past the point where, like, we can find special rooms and stuff. Magic Fingers costs us HP. How to jump is just bad, so doesn't really matter much. Okay, let's pray for some chests. Oh, wait, there's a secret room here. Super Greed, pretty much, you know, at this point, there's not much you can do. Not much you expect from secret rooms. Getting a little bit more money. Oh, it's a quarter. Lovely. I mean, we probably could have gotten 25 free plays of Magic Fingers, but I don't really think 25 plays of Magic Fingers is worth it anyway. Two items. Of course, we can't see. Pill generator, I can see forever. Means the Yo Listen kind of sucks now. And crying over spilled milk. Both are kind of trash, but. Oh well, what can you do? Actually, Explosivo is really good against Brownie. Holy crap. All things considered, right now we're just trying to pull out a win, considering how little HP we have. How badly things can go if we just screw up once. Items? No, no chests? Okay. And there's our boss. But we have to deal with three super envies right before it. Lovely. Probably one of the worst bosses we could be fighting with this setup. Though, actually, to be honest, it's not too bad, now that I think about it. Especially since we're in a large room. If this was three super envies in a normal room, I would probably take a billion damage. But we're gonna be fine. Second secret room is trash. And we'll just go finish this run. Goodbye, blue baby? No, I guess not. Thought you'd be dead by now, but... Yeah, okay, so we managed to win. Somehow, even though that run was kind of trash. Yawn, stretch out again. It at least registered now, so at least we're done with that. What do I want? Let's do an Eden run now. Yeah, let's do an Eden run. We got... That's an awful setup. Let's just restart. Crackjacks. And the D12. No thanks. Book of Shadows. I'm just gonna restart until we get a good start, pretty much. The poop. The straw and acid baby and 1 HP. Well, we're probably yeah, we're dead. That's kind of what happens when you have a bad run like that. These are just trash. Like what am I gonna do with the fanny pack and one more? This is good. Mom's box and PhD. Even if we have a shitty familiar like Isaac's head, our damage is bad, our fire rate is okay, speed is okay. We'll swap it out for Skinny Odd Mushroom right away. So we pretty much We're gonna try and get curved horn or cancer. Cancer puts us at the tears cap right there because of mom's box. No. Wake me up inside, can't wake up. Wake me up inside, save me, etc, etc. Mom's box is now useless, unless we get mom's purse. But at least we have a tick that does a lot now. Tough love. You know what? Sure. We have a decent luck stat, all things considered anyway, so... Yep. Oh, this is good. This is lovely. It means I probably just shouldn't use mom's box. This room is kind of awful. Way too many enemies that move erratically. Yeah, So, you know, I was looking forward to having mom's box this early on. And you know what we're gonna do? Instead, we're gonna use the tick. We're gonna just use a doubled tick. So I'm pretty sure that means that most bosses automatically lose like 30% of their HP at the start of the fight. Oh yeah, and I'll just take damage on a random spider. Means we can't go in there anymore. 3 portals is, you know, not good. Isaac's fork we can't take. Yeah, I'm a little salty right now. Because of the fact that, well, now we can't make use of this awesome item we have until we get something that gives us more trinket space. And also it means we can't, I think we're gonna die anyway, so. Right, what was I doing here? I was looking for... There was something I could bomb over here, I'm pretty sure. Bombing this. Swallowed penny is kind of useless, but the HP is really lovely right now. I guess we'll just go to the boss. I would go into the curse room, but I don't. Actually, you know what? Let's go into the curse room. I don't feel too attached to this run right now, so... I I can't even play you, so... Oh well. Ended up losing half a spirit heart, not that big of a deal. Especially because I think we'll get our HP back when we go into the boss fight because of the tick. Yeah. So he lost about 20% of his HP to start with, which, you know, doesn't really matter much. Makes the fight a little bit faster, but not a ton. We actually take 4 hits to destroy that. That's not good. I was like, oh, we're in a decent spot right now. But now we aren't. We are nowhere near a decent spot anymore. Our chance of a big damage or tears up is just gone. Unless we get lucky and get belly button from one of these bosses, or we get mom's purse from the shop. Which I don't want to go to right now because we don't have enough money. So even if it was there, I couldn't get it. And an HP upgrade. But actually, yeah, let's go to the shop. Because if mom's purse is there, it's great. And I can always bomb a donation machine. It is not here. So I just can't do it. Okay, let's go down to the next floor. This run isn't bad, it's just not good right now. We need more. And Curse of Darkness again, lovely. Oh, there's a Tinted Rock. We'll gladly spend my bomb on a Tinted Rock. Especially if we get our bomb back. Let me just walk into this fire for a sec. Okay. So we need to get a Devil Room. We really do need that at this point, I think. It would help a ton. But in our item room, we have something not that good. Admittedly, it's better than mom's box right now, but I'm gonna keep... It's not that good anyway. Wait, why do we get a luck up with mom's box? Admittedly, like, Giga Fart is so bad that I'd rather just hold on to Mom's Box anyway. Because we, even if it's just for the luck up, it's worth it. And if we get Belly Button or Mom's Purse, then we can start using it again and get trinkets. Oh, I would have loved to... Actually, that worked out. Spend one bomb on this. Get more money. Okay. We're gonna go back into the shop and I'm really gonna try and get mom's freaking purse. Really? You rerolled to the exact same thing. Nope. Not yet. And okay, that didn't work out. Oh, there's always next floor. Would also like to get that spirit heart, but I'm gonna need a bomb. Can't do that. As much as I would want to, Oh, that would have been, that would be nice, but oh well. Too bad for us. Something's wrong does like next to nothing. There's no chance of us actually killing those. I think we need to just focus on Ragman. Which is gonna be hard, all things considered, but he broke. We broke Ragman. We have to do this without getting hit. Please do not hit me. Please. Okay, that's one down. Two. And three. Phew. The box. Oh, Hagalaz, pheromones. Pick hell, Hagalaz. And Necronomicon. I did not mean to take it, but oh well. I guess we're taking it. Okay, let's go down. Black hearts are nice though, but not much else. That's not worth it. I was hoping I could open it before I take damage. But now I think we just lost all our black hearts already. We're still really lacking in meaningful stat ups. No, there goes our last black heart now. And that before the damage can hit again. Yeah, we lost our devil chance. This is kind of over, I think. We're stuck at base stats still. We're worse than base. Our damage is below average. We have the tick, which is useless. We have a spacebar item that is useless until we get some other item. And tough love, which is nice and all, but it's not reliable enough to pull us out of our whatever we're in right now. Like, we're dead. Okay, I think that's a good place for me to stop with Isaac. I am gonna switch over to Metroid. And I'll be back with that in just a few minutes, I guess.